It's Madden NFL 22, and today's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the Rams and the Ravens, and it comes your way next.
They love their crab cakes and they love their football. That's what Maryland does. And we are at M&T Bank Stadium down near the Inner Harbor of Baltimore. Here's a scene a short time ago. The Ravens introduced to this sellout crowd, and through a sea of pyrotechnics, out they came from the tunnel. We're set to go as the Ravens get ready to match up with the Los Angeles Rams.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you look at our two quarterbacks in this one. It's really a good matchup when you boil it down. Matthew Stafford of the Rams, Lamar Jackson of the Ravens.
And both of them have terrific ability to improvise. And that means when the first read's not there, how quickly can you go through your progressions? Can you hang in there and take a shot as you release it? Can you buy time outside of the pocket? Can you pull it down and run if need be? I think we'll see all of those traits on display in this one.
Here's the former Utah Ute, Matt Gay, to get this one started. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Time to see this wide open Baltimore offense go to work, and leading them, pretty darn good one, Lamar Jackson out of Louisville.
The best numbers that Lamar Jackson possesses is that his team wins the vast majority of games that he starts at quarterback. But in addition, 2,900 yards rushing in his career. They know how to build around him and play to his strengths.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
They go to Freeman again on second down. And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there, as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Now Jackson. He's going to look deep for Watkins. A leap, and he's got it. He got it. And they finally get him, but not before he reaches the 33-yard line.
Well, for Lamar Jackson, we know all about how dangerous he is running the football, but he can really sling it as well, and he connects on a big one there.
And what was amazing to me was the fact he was able to get as much on the ball as he did because he was on the run. Normally, when you're on the move like that, you don't expect the ball to go that far. You would think you need your lower body to be involved. That was an all-arm throw.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10.
And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done.
Get ready! Get ready!
And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that, and here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game, and all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ernest Jones. And the Rams are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. Rams taking the field, ready for their first offensive series, and led out by their new starter for 2021 in his now 13th season in the National Football League, Matthew Stafford.
And what big news it was back in January when news leaked out that Matthew Stafford was leaving Detroit and heading out west to join the Los Angeles Rams. The Rams are hoping he's the missing piece to the puzzle as they seek a Super Bowl title. Over 45,000 yards passing as a Lion, but not a single playoff victory in his entire tenure. The Rams general manager has said he can envision Stafford staying 5 to 8 years, which would take him into his 40s.
And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. It was Anthony Averett who got him down.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there, all 11 guys on defense, diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
On second and 9, Stafford. And he spots Henderson, open left side. So, Charles, first drive here, a little safe completion underneath. Maybe get some rhythm, get your feet wet, so to speak.
I agree, and I like it because it's a lot like a basketball game when you're getting started and you pass the ball around so everyone touches it early and gets involved in the game. In this case, it's not just dumping it to a back and he's able to run with the ball, but you get your offensive linemen involved because they get to get out and run and hit people in the open field. Everyone getting their feet wet early.
Brandon Stevens there on the tackle.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Here's Beckham now. It's a jet sweep. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
As a wideout, when you take that handoff and you come around the edge, you're expecting to see nothing but empty space in front of you. But if not...
Well, things can go south in a hurry, and that's exactly what we saw on that play with a loss. The Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third. From the gun, here's Stafford. Trying to get it to Beckham, and it's intercepted. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And the Ravens will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. Well, a shaky start for both quarterbacks now. We had the interception on the opening drive, and now they throw it right back to him.
So does that mean we're really kind of starting from the beginning, Brandon, right? Both of them have done it, so we kind of start from scratch. Looks to me like both of these defenses have done their homework, and they're executing quite well.
Lamar Jackson marching back onto the field. And he had to be pleased at the start of the last drive. The offense was moving, but certainly not pleased at the end result, an interception.
And every team we ever talk to, at some point in the conversation, the coach, player, someone talks about, you know, we've got to finish. We've got to finish off drives, finish off the game. There's an example there of not finishing, doing everything right, but not getting the result that you need.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. And he's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Second and 8 coming up.
Finish it up!
They run from the pistol here with Freeman. Pushing forward for three up to the 48. Now it's Jackson. Flushed out right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. The decision to tuck and run gets him three, but that's not enough. Now it's fourth.
And partner, I would guess that in his headset he was hearing from his coach, it's third down, don't take a sack. And in this case, he's able to avoid the pressure and get out of there. He doesn't get the first down, but he does turn a possible loss into positive yardage.
So on fourth down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away. Cooper Kupp deep for L.A. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad. So the Rams coming back onto the field, their second drive of the game. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Got a man open. It's Tyler Higbee. And brought down, but not before reaching the 25.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Play action. Stafford. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now it's Stafford. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Van Jefferson was the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
That was well defended. They clamped down on every available receiver. Just got to give the win to the defense on that snap.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. To throw on second and 10, Stafford. He'll get this one to Kupp, complete. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. The Rams with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a third down coming up. Henderson will try and run for the first. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
They had yet to run the ball at all on this drive, but third and short, definitely was a great time to dial one up.
Scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Off of play action, here's Stafford. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And this one is incomplete.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. On the handoff, Henderson. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
That's it, baby. We're going to work.
He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. Sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there, and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem. Think of it this way. Two of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
Now a first down throw, Stafford. And this is incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
Second and 10 now from the 27. Now a handoff, Henderson. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of 3. An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7. Back to throw, Stafford. It's caught by OBJ. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
Let's go, boy. Bring it on.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Five yards from the end zone, first and goal. They'll run here with Henderson. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. It'll be a gain of 5 there as they move closer. It's 2nd and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
2nd down and goal. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, up in the 6-yard line. Tyus Bowser gets him for a loss of 5. He is so tough to handle on the blitz, and that's Exhibit A.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense, so the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
So backed up to the 6 now, 3rd and goal. Throwing a Stafford. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Well, so a drive that spans all that time, and yet you may only come away with 3 points here.
Well, your defense, all right, they actually like these long drives. They get to rest over on the sidelines for a while. But when you're not finishing with points in terms of touchdowns, that's frustrating. They've got to figure out how to close out these long drives and get 6s instead of 3s.
And Gay knocks this one through. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. So a good kick there. They put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the 3.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
After the made field goal, Gay back out there to kick it off. Duvernay now going to bring it out.
And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
Here we go.
Baltimore about ready to go on offense.
And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's
on the first
drive. Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn it into first downs and hopefully points.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their own 18. Off the play fake, Jackson. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
I think we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Jackson going to hold on to it again. And it's a fumble. And the Rams have got it back. So that play, I mean, it was pretty well blown up from the start, and it results in a turnover.
Yeah, and when you're running the option like that as a quarterback, you have so many different keys and reads to make that sometimes as you're making them, you're not protecting the ball the way you should, and it gets popped free.
Here's a Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. Their drive last time, it stalled out there.
You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Following the fumble recovery, Stafford. It's caught, Beckham. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. This is Henderson. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 40 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Partner, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Second quarter, 2 minutes remain, 3-0 our score. Second and inches. Stafford. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Rams add on to their lead. That's why you've got your star out there. Throw the ball to him. They did.
That's simply saying we don't care what coverage you put out there. He's so good. We're going there with the football anyway, and there's not a thing you can do about it.
Inside the red zone, they go to him. He gets it done. Matt Gay on for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. The drive there only spanning three plays, and it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And he returns this to the 22.
Come on, baby, let's go. Get excited. Let's go. Let's go.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field.
And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. On first and 10, it's Jackson. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
First down now, but that clock rolling.
51, Mike. Mike, 51.
Here's Jackson. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So apparently some grabbing of the jersey there on the O-line.
Yeah, just working the interior, and that's where the penalty occurred.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Jackson now. Dancing to his left. Going deep here for Watkins. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about.
Don't do us like that.
So they're going to decline that and choose to bring up second down.
So did you feel like maybe this is just a mistake that they don't take the penalty
here? Yeah, possibly.
Either that or they feel like their defense just cannot be moved on very well, and they'd rather go ahead and use the downs.
So the illegal forward pass also costs them a down, and now it's second and long. Now it's Jackson. That's into the hands of the tight end, Boyle. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And with a third and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Jackson from the shotgun. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Here's Sam Cook now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And a fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 18-yard line. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. A good job in the pass zone. He finds his target, Beckham. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Second and 4. A give for Henderson running to the right, and he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and 4. If this defense wants to stay in this ballgame, they've got to start ending some drives. That helps.
And they have to look ahead at what they expect the offense to do, and right now with that lead, that's run the football. So you don't just stack the line of scrimmage. You have to get upfield and try and make some plays in their backfield.
The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. And defensively going with a dime set. Six DBs on third and four. Stafford. Over the middle to Beckham. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, a check of the next-gen stats in that first half for the Rams. And there were a few factors as to why they built this good size advantage, but the rushing numbers were not all that amazing. We'll see if they can pick it up in the second half. Meanwhile, for the Ravens, they too didn't do a whole lot in terms of rushing efficiency in that first half, as you can tell by the numbers there.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback. The Rams offense ready to begin quarter number three. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half, they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
A carry by Henderson to start the drive. Henderson, a first down and more. Oh, a solid stiff arm and some open field. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 68 yards on the ground for him so far. They had a chance to limit his yardage, but he was able to fight off that tackle.
So it's not just the responsibility of the guys who missed the tackles along the way. It's all 11 on defense, able to stop this guy, unable to do it on that play. They've got to find a way. How about his ability to break through and gain that yardage?
So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 47. Meanwhile, Stafford's throw here hauled in by Kupp. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
From the 39, Stafford throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Nowadays, quarterbacks don't mind throwing into coverage because of the confidence they have in their receivers to come down with the ball. But sometimes you have to be careful you don't get too confident and throw an interception.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. Now it's Henderson. And down he goes, but the stiff arm utilized effectively there. And it helps him move the sticks.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. To throw is Stafford. Open man, Higbee, the tight end. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a 2nd and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Only needing 2 yards on 2nd down. They'll fake the give. Now Stafford. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Patrick Queen, he brought the pressure on the blitz and he gets there for a loss of 12. Blitz came there from the inside and there just wasn't much resistance.
No, not at all. That means that defensively, they timed it up perfectly and matched up perfectly. They drew all the blockers to the other guys, left a free runner back to the quarterback. And you know what a free runner turns into? A free hitter.
So now Stafford and the Rams after the sack, and they're staring up at a 3rd and long. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. From the left hash, this from 53 yards out. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So put another 3 on the board. All things considered, a good opening drive to begin the 3rd quarter.
And as a defense, the way that this game is going, you're excited to see those points go on the board. Gives them a little bit of leeway to play with when they're out on the field, but they're real excited to see their offense score. Now they get to go out there and do their part.
After the made field goal, Gay back out there to kick it off. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Come on now. Let's go.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
The Ravens offense getting ready now for their first possession of the 2nd half. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the 2nd half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now 1st and 10 at their own 22. Off play action. Jackson rolling to his left. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's 2nd down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on 1st and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
2nd and 8. Now a handoff. It's Freeman. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a 3rd and about 4 more for a 1st. Throwing is Jackson. Looking left side for Watkins, and he's got him. And he will have a Ravens 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
All right, let's just go ahead and walk through this one pretty easily, right? Blast off the line of scrimmage, get downfield to a certain point, usually around 8 to 10 yards, turn around and make sure the quarterback sees your numbers and set yourself up for the pass.
A well-executed curl route by Charles Davis. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Jackson, option right. 1st down and more for Jackson. And brought down across the 50 to the 49-yard line.
Well, I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10.
Jackson running again.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively, because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball. But the assignment gets mixed up. That's the end result.
They run the option here on first and 10.
And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Well, he's had success running the football in this one. Yeah, that's undeniable. But that time, the defense was on to it.
And, partner, I think the more you see a play like this, the more they're able to diagnose it quicker and easier for them to defend it. I think you have to dress it up a little bit and show maybe some different formations and looks.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. And now Jackson will look to throw it. He's going deep for Brown. This throw incomplete, nearly picked off. And with his pedigree, he doesn't drop many of those. But third down coming up.
What we've seen so far in this game, they are not going to allow a big shot over the top. You can have whatever you want underneath. They'll give you that, but they're not going to let you beat them deep.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Here's Jackson to throw. Flush to his right. And Jackson, so tough to stop. He's got a first down, and he gives himself up there at the end.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. Outright, this is Boyle, the tight end. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Nick Boyle, a 20-yard touchdown.
And the Ravens are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third.
Well, we know someone just added to his touchdown passing total, but all he did was get the ball out quickly to his tight end and let him take care of business the rest of the way.
Justin Tucker for the extra point. And that'll make it 13-7. That time, a 9-play drive, and it's capped off by the Baltimore score. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
The Rams ready to go on offense. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. Stafford. Now this is taken in by the tight end Bryson Hopkins.
And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaken up on that last play. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. From the 32-yard line here, second and three. Now Henderson powers through, and he'll be brought down right around the 37.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a play fake and it's Stafford. Gets this into the hands of the tight end Higbee. And he'll go down and that will do it for the third quarter of action. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Rams out in front here. They've got control of the football as well as we get set for the fourth quarter. So in Raven territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 46. To the right side, this is Henderson. In to make the stop, Patrick Queen, the linebacker, the Ravens' leading tackler in 2020. Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. Again, it's Henderson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 99 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
They'll try the jet sweep. Stafford pops it forward.
And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Here's Henderson. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line.
I think there's a fatigue factor that's kicking in defensively. You know the will is still strong, but I think the offense is starting to bend it just a little bit, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. It's looked that way. We'll see if they can continue this already strong drive.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18.
From the red zone now, Stafford. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30.
Tyus Bowser picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field, down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of that.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. On the draw, this is Henderson. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Give him 6 on the run. It'll be third down now with still a long way to go to get to the first down marker.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Third and long, it's Stafford. Looking for the end zone. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown. Cooper Kupp, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams add on to their lead.
But that makes this a two-score ball game. And, you know, the way this thing has been going, Charles, two scores kind of feels like 3 or 4 scores.
Yeah, that's a great observation. It's been a heck of a battle, hasn't it? And points have been at a premium throughout this game. So you have to wonder, is this going to be too much for them to overcome?
And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs, and I think they're going to at least take a look at this. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
Attaboy, baby.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right.
Now Stafford will come up, try to get his guys a 2-point conversion. Stafford's going to try and throw for it, and he's got it. So the 2-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead.
And of course, on the 2-point try, had the option to run or pass. They pass it there, and it works.
Felt pretty straightforward, didn't it? An open receiver, ball's put on him, 2 points for them.
After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away.
On the return, Devin Duvernay. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
Let's go.
And Baltimore's offense set for this next possession.
After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10, just shy of the 30. Throwing to start the drive. Jackson swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You've got the first one for the second one to even matter.
On second down, Freeman. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
Second and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
They run, Devontae Freeman. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
From the 44, Jackson. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. From midfield now, here's Jackson. Oh, he's going to go for it all. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You still have to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
Clock running here, under 90 seconds to go. Here's Jackson. Steps away to his left. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown.
Geez, I mean, what more can you say about Lamar Jackson? We know that he's got the quickness and the agility, but you know, if you wanted proof of his straight line speed, look no further.
And normally when you see guys moving this fast, it might be a fly pattern from a receiver or a toss sweep from a tailback or something like that. This was designed as a passing play, and then he got out of the pocket, and he just took off, and he just kept gaining momentum with every step.
Tucker now for the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. So that drives 7 plays in length. And it was capped off by the touchdown run that came from Lamar Jackson. So a 7-point game, they'll need a recovery, the touchdown, and an extra point to tie. And the hands team for the Rams able to secure the football. A tough one there. They certainly wanted that one. They needed it, but they didn't absolutely have to get it. They still do have 3 timeouts.
You're exactly right. They had to attempt it. But even though they didn't get it, as you noted, with 3 timeouts, if they can get these stops on defense, all hope is not lost.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
Henderson now on 1st and 10. And I think we've got a hold here. It's a 5-yard pickup for the moment. Let's see what our referee says. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well.
So that time they get the tight end on the hold.
Normally he's a pretty good run blocker, but this time he just didn't get his arms extended and let go quickly enough. The flag came out as a result.
Now a give, right side. It's Henderson. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Again, it's Henderson. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. On third down, here's Henderson. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game. Here's Johnny Hecker now as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line.
You hate to give the ball away here in the fourth quarter while you're just holding a slim lead. But that punt, absolutely ideal. They pin them inside the 5-yard line. They give their defense a really nice opportunity.
Jackson and the Ravens, here they come. Down 21-14. A little over 50 seconds remaining. Staring them in the face is the need to go 97 yards. No easy task as they come up on first and 10. Jackson to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete.
When you're backed up this deep, sometimes defenses sacrifice coverage for pass rush because they know you can only go so far on your pass drop. You've got the back of the end zone. So they came after him. He took the shot downfield. He didn't connect, but boy, that was force against force.
Second and 10. Throwing, Jackson, connecting with Andrews, but the defense on him quickly at the 6-yard line. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion, but I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication, and as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
We'll be right back.